So I want to talk a little bit more about the Blue Star Mysteries and what it means to truly lead and serve this planet. And I'm thinking about Grandmother Twyla when I said one time that I was a servant to something, and she said, I do not like the word servant. I think maybe some of that might have come from the background when she was a little girl being taken off the reservation and put into a different home where she was not permitted to live her teachings or even speak her own language, those sort of things, when she was a child. But the idea of being a servant was not something she liked. She did love the word service, to be of service. And so that got me to thinking about, so how can we be of service and be leaders? And what does it mean to be a leader? And what's come to me very strongly is that one of the ways that we lead is by being of service. When others see us serving the good, serving the whole, serving life, doing what's life-giving, and bringing wholeness to ourselves, to our families, to our communities, to our loved ones, and also bringing that wholeness to others that we don't know, sometimes helping complete strangers out, and certainly wishing or sending or doing what we can to offer help, for instance, in the relief and efforts that happen when there's catastrophes, not just in the United States, not just in Texas or Florida, but in Puerto Rico or the Philippines or wherever it might be around the entire world, that there's a recognition that we are being of service, that we're serving humanity, that we're serving the planet. We're serving everything. When we serve others who are in need, we're also serving ourselves. When any of us is suffering, when any of us is out of balance, there's a way in which we're all connected. And a lot of people, unfortunately, have forgotten that. And so one of the creatures that Grandmother Twyla taught about and taught me about was this creature. And this is the talon of a wild turkey. And so this particular turkey came to me from a friend who had actually found this turkey that was no longer with us. So, and it came to her, and then she gave it to me. And when she gave it to me, she said, it's because you're a planetary worker, Star Wolf, you serve the planet. And so when Grandmother Twyla was doing my animal totems with me many years ago, one of the main totems that came up was wild turkey, and I didn't know a whole lot about it. And I said something like, wild turkey? Well, I'm from Kentucky, and wild turkey means something else on a Saturday night, you know, to a lot of people. And she said, no, the wild turkey is very sacred. The turkey gives the very best that it has to offer. The earliest peoples here ate the turkey, revered the turkey, and when the boat people came over from Europe, as they were called, one of the ways they were fed is through the turkey, learning how to eat that in this country and to sustain them. And so the turkey serves humanity and serves actually the planet. But I want to speak a little bit more about finding our place in the family of things. And that's how I think we best serve. I think that's how I best serve. That if I truly want to be a leader in the world, that I must learn how to follow nature's sage advice, how to follow the wisdom of water and earth, fire and air, and trust the great mystery or the great spirit or the animating force in all of these things. I don't have to understand it. That's why it's called the great mystery. It's always a mystery. It's always a surprise. And each time we walk or I walk in nature by a river or a stream, I never know if I'm going to see a blue heron or find a shell or a particular stone or see certain creatures in the water or look up in the air and see the eagle flying over fishing or sit by a tree that and lean against it and start dreaming and start having a vision. Nature is always in communication with us. It's always teaching us. And nature, of course, the elemental beings, is a part of us, not apart from us. And it's constantly giving us a feedback loop. It's constantly saying, this is balanced, this is beginning to get off balance, this is horribly out of balance. And this is the way our body speaks to us too. Not just our physical body, but our emotional world, our mental world, when it starts chattering too much or just kind of goes brain dead, we realize we're on overload, we've blown a few circuits, that happens to me sometimes when I work too much or travel too much. It's like, okay, ding, 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 time for rest, time to go brain dead, you know, time to just go mindless for a while. So constantly we have this feedback loop with nature, the nature within here, the nature out here. And this nature belongs to our beautiful planet, and it belongs to all of us. But not only belongs to this planet, it belongs to our universe. You know, uni means one. And to say that we're part of a universe means we're part of the whole thing. We're part of everything here on this one planet, you know, one Earth. We're also one solar system of many. And really the lines that we draw around something and say, well, this is my house, my town, my community, my state, my region, my country, my world, my place in the solar system, my place in the galaxy, one galaxy in millions of galaxies, you know, within one universe. And now science is really blowing our mind and saying, oh, there may be at least another universe. So then what will we call it? You know, a bioverse? You know, or, and that one may mirror this one in some other kind of way, or there could be unlimited amount of verses, other kinds of verses. But ultimately it comes back to me, the idea of uni, of one. That there is a oneness. There is a oneness, whether it's the far reaches of space and beyond space and time, there is a feedback loop that's saying to us and reverberating all the way down to the single cell organisms, to this minutiae of particles, of atoms, to our wide diversity just on this planet, that we are all interconnected. So what do? Do we separate ourselves out and pretend that we're different, we're somehow special, we're somehow unique because we're this or that, or because we're a certain color, or because of certain economic standard or particular country that we live in, this kind of we're the best. There's one thing to feel proficient in what we do and to feel successful and to feel victorious. It's another to feel victorious over others by defeating someone or something else, by lessening another person, another race, another sexual preference, another age. Ageism to me is really big right now in my psyche, you know, to constantly be looking to be better in that way over someone. It's one thing to be our personal best and to be in relationship to everything and serving everyone and everything as best we can from that place. It's another to need to downgrade other things in order to feel better about ourselves. I think that's called bullying, you know? I think it's called cosmic bullying. So I just want to speak again into this mystery, that the Blue Star Mysteries really are about remembering who it is that we are, remembering to fully embody that wherever we are in the cosmos, and bringing that love and that service to everyone and everything and to our own selves. And as we do that in that serving, we then unconsciously, perhaps even without even knowing it, we lead others by example.